Dear friends, welcome to another video. This is Nick from educate.tv and today we're going to take a quick first look at this ATTiny85 board. Without any further delay, let's get started. I wanted to take a look at this tiny board for a long time. It is a very small board in size, it is low cost and it uses a different processor than the Arduino boards. It uses the ATTiny85 microcontroller chip, which can operate at a frequency up to 20 MHz. It has 8 kilobytes of flash memory, 512 bytes of RAM memory and 6 input-output pins, two of which can implement the I2C protocol. It is very small in size and has low power requirements. We can program it using the Arduino IDE, which makes things so much easier. I got this tiny board with a USB interface in order to be easier to program. You can find a link for this ATTiny85 board in the description of the video. I wanted to test if the ATTiny85 board is a good option for simple projects and if we can achieve longer battery life with this board than with a standard Arduino Pro Mini. Let's find out together. At first, we have to download the appropriate drivers in order the board to work with your computer. After trying a lot of different drivers for my Windows 8.1 installation, the one that works comes from this website. Next, we have to add the ATTiny85 board in the Arduino IDE. We go to File, Preferences, and we enter this URL to the Additional Boards Manager URL field. Next, we press OK. Next, we go to Tools, Board, Boards Manager, we select the Digistamp AVR package and we select Install. After a few seconds, our board is ready to use with the Arduino IDE. In order to program this board, we have to follow a different procedure than the one we follow with Arduino boards. At first, we select the board, we select DigiSpark, default at 16.5 MHz. Next, we write our code and we press the Upload button with the board still unplugged. The bottom status box will ask you to plug your DigiSpark port. After doing so, the code will be uploaded to the board and the program, the standard blink sketch in this example, will run. Now that we know how to program the ATTiny board, let's modify the blink program in order to measure its power consumption. So in this example program, the LED stays on for a second and stays off for 3 seconds. I have connected a multimeter and as you can see, the ATTiny board needs around 13 milliamps of current. If we put ATTiny to sleep using the code I will provide, we can drop the current draw to around 4 milliamps. Still not low enough, so I took more drastic measures. I removed the power LED, which stays on all the time, and I removed the regulator and I provide power to the ATTiny chip directly. Still, the current draw is high, about 2 milliamps when the chip is sleeping. It seems the USB circuit requires a lot of current all the time, so this board is not suitable for low power applications. I think we have to use a bare ATTiny chip if we want to greatly reduce its power consumption. As a final thought, from my experience with the board, I can say that it is a nice small board with limited capabilities. It is useful for small projects that require few lines of code, but the power consumption is not low. An Arduino Pro Mini at sleep needs less current, costs around the same, and offers more pins, memory, and functionality. For me, the Arduino Nano or the Arduino Pro Mini is a better option if the bigger size of these Arduino boards is not an issue. If you need the minimum possible board size, the ATTiny is a good option. What do you think about the ATTiny USB board? Have you managed to further reduce the power consumption of it? If you have any tricks or advice, please post your comments in the comment section below. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.